You just went through the first challenge. What did you feel? Okay, somebody felt good energy. What did you feel, men? What did you feel? If I ask you what you think, you'll be able to tell me. But if I ask you what you feel, you'll go, oh, well, kind of like my husband. All right, so what we want to do in the world where we are right now, in the artificial intelligence, which is coming up very fast and furiously on one side, is to support it on the other side with our human qualities, which is based on feeling. So, oh, now I need my little clicker. Thank you very much. Okay, so some of you, maybe you joined in, maybe you didn't, because your brain jumped in. Your brain jumped in and said, oh, this is stupid. It makes me feel stupid. I don't want to clap. I don't want to do this. Your brain stopped your body from doing an action that is absolutely simple to do. But those that followed their body and their instinct and their impulse and their intuition, those of you made the first step to feeling something. Your brain is now in control of your body. It doesn't work that way. The body is there to make the brain or allow the brain to function. Our focus is all wrong in this world today. So I did a little research and I realized, talking about industrial revolutions, I'll show you how stupid I am. I thought maybe there were only three of them and I found out, oh my God, no, we're in the fourth one. We're in big data, robotics, and AI. That means it's getting faster and faster and faster and more information, the age of information. And all of us are in a point where we're going into burnout. We're getting overload. The body, the person is getting overload. Our workforce is getting overload. But here's our hope. Look, the futurists are out there saying now, the next industrial revolution is humanity. I think we see it happening. All our young people, the way we're sharing cars, the way we're sharing ideas, it's going that direction. And this is where we have to go. They're already projecting that in the future. When we make that step, maybe I'm alive to see it, maybe not. But that is where we're going. Because if we keep trying to compete with what's happening with the artificial intelligence and the robotics and the big data, we will just burn totally out. We cannot compete with that kind of technology as a person. So we have to start to develop our part of human qualities that the robot can't do. I come from the theater. I had my own business for 25 years, and the last 7 years I've been going around the world teaching performers, whether it's business people or people that want to be on the stage. I got a telephone call a while back. This is what I think is most important. Think less, feel more. I do not say don't think. Of course we need to think, but we've got to feel more. I got a telephone call from London Business School and they said to me, Kim, we want you to take this automotive firm. It was a big one. And they said, we want you to train our executives for one day. And we want you to teach those executives what can they learn from an actor. And I thought, okay, an actor, one day. Something that's sustainable that they will remember later on. What can I do? Well, number one, here's what I wanted to do. They have to have their soft skills. Every actor has these. They work very much on internal to find out these things so that they can sense what's happening. Mind and body, mind connected with the body, 360 degrees. I'm connecting with people. I feel what you're feeling. So that's very, very important. For me, that was one of my jobs, to teach these 26 executives in a day how to come to this conclusion. So I took them, well, first of all, to the world of the artist. I took them to the theater. I made them all actors. I gave them a project from beginning to end. And these are the things that I feel are very important for anyone that's in business, anyone that's in any kind of communication with other people. Make them think differently. Make them feel something. If you want them to, the idea to be sustainable, they have to feel something. You begin with the individual, because if the individual, executive or employee, it doesn't matter. You begin with the individual. And from the individual, when they change, you'll be able to change the situation. We alter the patterns to access new viewpoints, and of course, we play roles. So, this was their Aufgabe, their homework for one day. They were given roles in advance, which they had to memorize, in maybe not their mother language. Excuse me, I have to get some water. They had to do challenge after challenge. And what happens? They hit blocks. They hit blocks where, oh, I don't want to do this. Oh, I can't do this. I won't do this. Because I keep putting it into a very, very tight time schedule, what they have to learn. So eventually, they begin to overload. And when they overload, then they begin to feel something. The emotions come up. And when the emotions come up, they're authentic. And they begin, by the end of the day, they're all connecting together. Because they understand each other. They see the other person having problems with something. And they become empathetic. This is what we want. This is what we need. So we all started alone, monologue alone for your colleagues, trying to put out these words. Boy, boy, boy. That's tough. And then they end with a whole project at the end of the day all together. And they have many challenges along the way. Here's where we are today. If that were a person, look at the size of that brain. We value, and I'm sorry, you're all here, you're men, and I understand technology is important and all the information is important, but we have put so much emphasis on titles, on knowledge, on technology, that our brains are getting so big that we are not connected to our bodies. We don't feel anymore. We don't sense what's going on anymore. We don't think it's important. People that have had the degrees and the doctors, they're the important ones. And those that work with their bodies aren't really important. The problem with this is the body starts to send out signals that you are not listening to. It's sending out the headache. It's sending out the lower back pain. It's sending out whatever it might be that you can't sleep. And if you don't take notice of it, it goes right into burnout and heart attacks. Because you weren't listening. You're too busy up there in your brain. So, if I can do anything, I would get you to start to concentrate on what you feel. Take the time to take a second and say, what am I feeling? So, transfer this concept into the business. Up above, the executive board in a huge company is basically focusing on financials and future and new technology and they're up there. But down below, the people that are working are feeling like we aren't connected. We don't feel like the information is working as well as it can. What can we do about this? If we don't pay attention to it, we start having sickness in your workforce. We have little small revolutions in your workforce. We have people that really honestly are unengaged. Why should they be engaged? Because the connection isn't happening. It's getting too distanced. And we have to somehow come back together. How do we do this? My theory, and this is what I've been doing for quite a few years now. we have to come back to the me to we connection. I'm a leader, that's clear. I'm me, that's clear. But I'm only as good as the people around me. I've got to use and synergize with those around me. And we have to work, if this looks like I'm talking about up and down, I'm talking about circle. There is no up and down. There is no vertical. And the vertical world, business world we're working in is falling apart. It's not working anymore because everything, our information, is going horizontal. It's going horizontal, and if we don't wake up, those businesses are going to have really problems. So we have to find a way to connect in. I teach team building, I teach executive leadership, and I feel that it's important that we start to connect our body and our mind.